morning, my dear students. I am Subramaniam, Department of Social Science. Now we discuss about Economics, Unit 2, Employment in India and Tamil Nadu. Introduction. The employees, the employers, and employment structure in India. Three sectors of economy, the structure of employment, types of employment, organized sectors and unorganized sectors, public sector and private sector, difference between the public sector and private sector, employment pattern, employment trend in Tamil Nadu. Okay, introduction. You know, the basic needs of every human beings are food, clothes and shelter. These are the important necessary for the human beings. The food, cloth, shelter. Okay. In present world, one more essential need has to be added in this list. That is the employment. To survive in the world, we all need employment in your money. The employees. Those who are engaged in the economic activities in whatever capacity, high or low, are called the employees. What is meant by employee? Those who are engaged in the economic activities in whatever capacity, high or low, are called the employees. Next, employers. What is meant by employers? People who employ these workers and pay reward for their work are called the employers. Next one, the labor force of the economy. What is meant by labor force of the economy? The labor force of the economy is the number of people in the country who work and also capable of working. We take the age group of 15 to 60 years for the computation of workforce. I mean, the persons who are less than the 15 years are considered as children, and persons who have crossed 60 years of age are excluded as they are not physically fit to undertake the productive occupation. I mean, the persons who are less than 15 years are considered as children, and persons who have crossed 60 years of age are excluded as they are not physically fit to undertake productive activities. If large percentage of the population is accounted by children and old age person, then the progress of the country would be very slow as the working force is very small. Besides, the small working force will have to maintain the large non-working force for feeding out of the small national product. Okay, next reading, employment structures in India. The nature of employment in India is multidimensional. I mean, the nature of employment in India is multidimensional. Some get employment throughout the year. Some others get employed for only a few months in a year. Next, three sectors of economy. Three sectors of economy are primary or agricultural sector, secondary or industrial sector, and tertiary or service sector. Primary sector, I mean the basic production, agriculture, forestry, mining, fishery. These are called the primary sector. These are the basic production sector. Next one, secondary sector, the production of goods and industries. Tertiary sectors are service sectors. Tertiary sectors are the service sector. Okay, the structure of employment. The structure of employment denote the number of workers engaged in different sectors of the economy, though the occupational pattern varies from one country to another. And one can find that developing countries like India, that large workforce will be engaged in the primary sector, while a small proportion in secondary and tertiary sectors. I mean, the small portions are engaged in the secondary and tertiary sectors in India. Whereas in well-developed countries, in proportion of workforce engaged in agriculture will be very small. I mean, in the developed countries, the proportion of workforce engaged in agriculture will be very small. And a majority of labor force will be in the industrial and tertiary sector. Employment has always featured as an important element of development policy in India. Employment growth has increased at an average rate of 2% during the past 4 decades since 1972 to 1973. Do you know, in the medieval period, the Firoza Tughlaq, the Sultan of Delhi, had set up an employment bureau to solve the unemployment problem. Who started the solve the unemployment problem? The Firoza Tughlaq, the Sultan of Delhi. He set up an employment bureau to solve the unemployment problem. Okay, next, the types of employment. First, organizer sector. The organizer sector is an that is incorporated with the appropriate authority or government and follow the appropriate rules and regulations. The government sectors followed the rules and regulations. In short, the organized sector are those which are deliberately planned, designed, and duly sanctioned by employment authority. They are formal by nature. The organized sectors are formal by nature. In India, employees of central and state government, they are formal by nature. In India, employees of central and state government, for example, banks, railways, insurance, industries, and so on, can be called the organized sector. What are the organized sector? What are the called organized sector? For example, banks, railways, insurance, industries. These are organized sector. This sector works according to certain rules and regulations given in the law. The organized sector has some formal process and procedures. The employees in the sector are provided with the job security, receive higher wages than those of the unorganized sectors. I mean, the organized sector provided with the job security and higher wages. Organized sector gives good salary, fixed working hours, and paid holidays, and provide the medical allowances and insurance also. Next one, unorganized sector. Unorganized sector of the economy characterized by the household manufacturing activity and small scale industry. These industries, jobs here are low paid and often not regular. Mostly, they do not have paid leave and holidays. leave due to the sickness and so on. The employment is not secure in the unorganized sector. When there is no work, people are asked to leave the job. This sector includes a large number of people who are employed on their own doing small jobs, such as selling on the street, doing repair work and so on. In the unorganized sector, the employment terms are not fixed and regular. They do not enjoy any special benefits or job security. These enterprises are not registered with the government. Which sector not registered in the government? Unorganized sectors not registered with the government. Next one, the public sector and the private sector. Economic activities are classified into public and private sector based on who own assets and it responsible. Economic activities are classified into public sector and private sector based on the who own assets and responsible for the delivery of services. Okay, next thing, the differences between the public sector and private sector. Public sector and private sector. Public sector is a service motive. Private sector is a profit motive. Public sector is a government owned the assets. Private sector, the private individuals own the assets. Public sector, the wages are paid by the government. In private sector, the wages are paid by the owner of the private enterprises. Examples, NLC, Neyveli Lignite Corporation. SAIL, Steel Authority India, Steel Authority of India Limited. BSNL, Bharat Sanchar Nigam Limited. Private sector examples, TVS Motors, Ashok Leyland, Tata Steel. Next, employment pattern. In recent years, there has been a change in the employment pattern, and this has helped in the employment to develop the more flexible working patterns among their employees. The trend are increasing self-employment, the firm using the fewer full-time employees and tending to offer more short-term contracts. There has been a growth in part-time employment. This may be due to lifestyle of the people. I mean, the employment pattern changed due to the lifestyle of the people. Next, employment trends in Tamil Nadu. Agriculture, despite a sharp decline in gross domestic product, they continues to be the large employer in Tamil Nadu. This is because the non-agricultural sector are yet to generate enough employment to affect a shift of labor force. Most of the employment growth in Tamil Nadu has been contributed by the unorganized and informal sectors. Okay, okay students, important points of this lesson. Point number one, the labor force is the number of people, in the country who work and also capable of working. Second point, the structure of employment denotes the number of workers engaged in different sectors of the economy. The employment growth rate. The employment growth rate of India increased at an average rate of 2% during past 4 decades from 1972 to 1973. Organized sector provide job security and other benefits like insurance to its employees. Public sector means the government undertaking. Employment pattern changes due to lifestyle of these people. Okay, students, thanks for watching.